And then there was one. We're talking about Blockbuster stores, only one left in the U.S.
A moment of silence. And then we get excited because Jill Sweat is with us today for the buzz.
Good to be with you.
Did you guys have Blockbuster cards?
Oh, absolutely.
The little animated cards?
Friday night was a big night in our house.
That's right. Yeah. Make it a Blockbuster night was
there
your
you
jingle.
Go.
All right. The only remaining Blockbuster video store, though, is now going to be in Bend, Oregon. Two locations in Alaska set to close their doors next week. So that will leave the Oregon store as the very last operating Blockbuster video store in the U.S. Now there are locations still operating overseas, so you'd have to jump on a plane to go, I guess. Well, at its peak in 2004, there were over 9,000 Blockbuster video stores in operation. Mm. Hey, wow. A little bit of trivia about Bend, Oregon. Mm. All right.
I wonder why this store.
Okay. What do you think the population is of Bend, Oregon?
Oh, gosh, I don't know where to start.
Well, in 2016, they said they had 91,000 plus people.
Okay.
It is the seventh most populous city in Oregon. So I guess that's the reason why they decided to do that. Mm-hmm. And they have a location of Oregon State there.
Okay.
So
you still wonder, who is going to video stores
now? Especially if you're in a college town.
Because they're not going.
They're watching things on Netflix.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
But, you know, I guess we should make a shrine now that Netflix. Or to Blockbuster.
A moment of silence.
I know,
It was
crazy.
Just nostalgia. Yeah.
I know.
All right, guys, here's another one. Angie.
More signs of the time here.
Yeah.
Even though the bankruptcy and closure of Toys R Us was the end of an era, the iconic mascot, Jeffrey the Giraffe, found a new home at a children's hospital in New Jersey. Mm-hmm. A statue of the giraffe was unveiled at Bristol-Myers Squibb Children's Hospital this week. The 16-foot-tall, 550-pound fiberglass statue used to stand at the company's Wayne, New Jersey headquarters. Jeffrey's new home in Brunswick, the hospital employees hope he will continue to bring joy to children for years to come.
Because being a Toys R Us kid was just like the coolest thing.
Just another, Blockbuster gone, Toys R Us gone. I think, but times change, you know?
Well, I think a lot of people are shopping online, Amazon and all of these different things. And so this is kind of the fallout, the result of what happens when we take everything online. And it's costing a lot of people jobs, and it's so sad.
You know, I guess kind of the fact of the matter is, all businesses don't last forever. You know, so
nothing lasts forever.
Nothing lasts forever. We're getting deep here.
We really are. But you know what does last forever? The value of art. And this is absolutely amazing. An Egyptian speed painter creates portraits upside down. Yeah. Albert Magdi uses two brushes to paint famous Middle Eastern and international celebrities. The 23-year-old often performs for audiences, and he doesn't paint to just create an image on some canvas, but also to amaze his audience in order to keep them active and attached to his work. Each painting takes him 3 to 4 minutes to complete. Yeah. The young artist says he has been painting upside down for several years and says it is difficult for him to create art in a traditional way. You know, we had a meteorologist some years ago by the name of Scott Padgett, and he used to, during his weather segment, he would do a sketch, but it was done the traditional way, but he would do a sketch of whoever. He did one of me, I think he did some viewers or whatever, and so it's really interesting to see how people can do stuff that quick.
It's so fast.
So quick.
Yeah, 3 minutes?
Right. I don't think, no. No, nowhere close to that.
No,
well,
I could do a stick figure.
Maybe like 10 times that amount of time. Give me like 3 hours and maybe we'll get there.
Yeah. That is a serious talent.
Indeed, and that is today's buzz.
All right.